There's no such thing as a failed home inspection. Hi, I'm Nick McLean, owner of the Nick McLean Real Estate Group, and we always recommend our clients get a home inspection prior to purchase. Now, I know what you're thinking. Of course I'll get a home inspection anytime I buy a home. Well, actually, to get a home inspection contingency, which protects your earnest money, the buyer and the seller have to agree. And so we always go into negotiating knowing that we need to negotiate on our buyer's behalf to get that home inspection contingency to protect their earnest money. But there's a lot of misconceptions when it comes to the home inspection and how the process works. And so I'm shooting this video to kind of to educate you on the actual process that we see day in, day out. And so part of the home inspection contingency, there's a time period. So once you go under contract, you have 10 days normally to do a home inspection. Now, you can negotiate a different timeline, maybe 14 days or 16 days or even 8 days, maybe even 2 days. And from that time period, you can then get a professional home inspector to inspect the property. Now, professional home inspectors are licensed in the state of Washington. And so when they inspect the home, they have a set list of items they need to look at. And if you've done a home inspection in the past, the items may have changed over the years. If you've never done one, I'm going to go over it. Now, state law requires that we refer at least 3 home inspectors to our clients. And so I actually have a list right here of home inspectors that we refer. There's 7 on the list now, but we're actually updating the list because there's more home inspectors in the marketplace right now. And so we've used probably 10 different home inspectors this year, maybe even a dozen different professional home inspectors. And each one will go over the exact same items, right? So, you know, how do you choose the right one? Well, you might choose them based on their experience, their customer service, maybe some experiences that we've had with them. And so they're gonna go into the house and not give a pass-fail of the home. They're only gonna report findings. So they're gonna look at the, you know, the electrical and the foundation and the exterior and the interior. They're gonna get up on the roof. They're gonna go in the crawl space, if there's a crawl space. They're gonna get in the attic. You know, they're looking for moisture. They're looking for any damages. So they're gonna make note of recommendations and safety and health concerns, right? Those are just findings. The seller is not obligated to fix any of it. See, the home inspection is for the buyer's protection. So we recommend you get that so you know what you're getting yourself into, or at least are more educated in the home. Because eventually, the plan is you're gonna buy the home and you're gonna own it. So I see this as a time to be educated on how or what you need to do to the home once you own it. Now, some items you weren't expecting at all. And so there's a process to ask the seller for any modifications or repairs. So you're gonna get this list. And it could be a long list. You have to remember the home inspector's job is to point out everything they see. Not just major things, everything they see. And even just make recommendations. So you get to choose which items you're gonna ask the seller to repair or modify. Now you also can just accept it the way it is and move towards closing. Because the quicker you accept the recommendation, you know, you're okay with it, you're gonna move forward, the sooner you can order the appraisal and move towards closing. But you wanna ask for repairs or modifications. I suggest you take the most important items and ask the seller to do that. Oftentimes, I've seen buyers ask for so many little things that it comes across as nitpicky, right? Like a honey-do list of little things that could just be really, really minor, really, really minor. So you could ask for repairs and modifications. The seller does not have to agree. So the seller actually has 3 days normally, I say normally because it could be different in writing, to respond to your request for modifications or repairs. And they can respond with, yes, I'm gonna do all of them. No, I won't do any of them. Or how about I do this instead? And this instead could be half of the list, one item on the list, or maybe concession on price or other considerations. Now, if the seller rejects your proposal or even makes a counter in some fashion, you then have a few days or a couple days to respond to that. Now, if you can't reach an agreement by the end of your contingency, you need to make a decision. Are you gonna terminate, get your earnest money back, and find another home? Or have you reached an area that is acceptable to you as the buyer and you wanna move towards closing? And I actually have an example of, it's called an inspection response form, right? An inspection response form the process we use. So I want to offer this to everyone watching this video. If you would like our list of refer inspectors that we refer, leave a comment. I'll send it to you. Also, inspection response form, how the process works so you're better prepared. Now, if you own a home, it's really important you understand this process, because the goal is to sell your home to a buyer, and to know what a buyer will do is very important. So as homeowners, you need to understand, your home doesn't have to pass an inspection to sell. Oftentimes I have clients that there's things wrong with their home. They don't want to put the money into it. They don't have the money to do the repairs, and they think they can't sell it in the current condition. You can. You can absolutely sell in current condition. Now, it's a case-by-case basis. I would like to see your home and see what repairs you're talking about, because some repairs the lender is going to require. But for the most part, for the inspection process, if the buyer is willing to take on the new repairs, then absolutely the buyer can choose to buy your home. So don't be scared of having some things before you go on the marketplace. Now, there's a lot to be said about having your home pre-inspected and then also, you know, uncovering those items and then fixing those items so that you can sell your home to the buyer knowing that there's nothing wrong, right? That can really help your price be higher. There's a lot to be said about that. But that's not always the case for some people. Some owners just don't have that ability to do it. Or maybe they live across the country and they're not gonna take care of those items. They just wanna sell it as is. And that's something that we do quite often. So we have a couple things for you. The home inspection list, the inspection response form, as well as any questions you have. Reach out to us. I'll answer any question you have on the home inspection process. I hope this helped. I know it will help. So get out there, be educated. And the more educated you are, the better decisions you're gonna make in the home buying process.